And now onto our dinosaur of the day, Rapetosaurus, which was a request from Paleo Mike via our Patreon and Discord, so thanks. Rapetosaurus was a titanosaur sauropod that lived in the Cretaceous in what is now Madagascar, in the Mahajanga basin. It was quadrupedal and herbivorous, and estimated to be 49 feet or 15 meters long. A juvenile was about 26 feet or 8 meters long, and so the estimate is that the adult was probably about twice as long.
Not so big for a titanosaur.
True. One specimen found is probably an adult, and based on its femur, that one is estimated to be 54 feet or 16 and a half meters long and weigh 10.3 tons. Rapetosaurus had a relatively gracile skeleton. The skeleton has similarities to brachiosaurids and other titanosaurs, so it had a long neck and large body. The forelimb is about 87% the length of the hind limb. It had a slender tail. It had long vertebrae. And juveniles didn't really have this, but as an adult, it had osteoderms. The skull was like a diplodocid, long and narrow. An adult skull is estimated to be 15.7 inches or 40 centimeters long, and it had nostrils at the top of the skull.
That's cool that they found a skull. That doesn't happen all the time.
Mm-hmm. And it had pencil-like teeth, so that means it could strip leaves.
So also similar to a diplodocid.
The type and only species is Rapetosaurus krausei. It was found by a field team from Stony Brook University and members from nearby Université d'Antananarivo. The team leader, David Krause, had been digging at the site in Madagascar since 1993. It was described and named in 2001 by Christina Curry Rogers and Catherine A. Forster, and the genus name comes from Rapeto, a mischievous giant of Malagasy folklore.
That's cool.
Yeah, and then the species name, you can probably guess, is in honor of David Krause. The holotype is an adult skull, and referred specimens include a juvenile skeleton and more skull elements. The juvenile skeleton was found directly associated with a well-preserved partial skull. So Rapetosaurus is one of the most complete known titanosaurs, and it helped show what a titanosaur skull looked like, and it also helped show that Nemectosaurus and Chisatosaurus are titanosaurs, because they're only known from skulls. It also helps shed light on sauropod classification and helps to show what other titanosaurs probably looked like, the ones where only partial skeletons were found. In 2012, Christina Curry Rogers found a juvenile when looking through crocodile fossils at the State University of New York at Stony Brook, and she recognized it as a miniature titanosaur because she'd spent 15 years studying titanosaurs. These juvenile fossils were found in Madagascar in 1998 and 2003, but were misclassified. So Christina Curry Rogers and others did histology and CT scans to figure out how Rapetosaurus grew, and it turns out it grew fast. It grew around the same rate as elephants. So at birth, Rapetosaurus was estimated to weigh about 7.5 pounds or 3.4 kilograms, and based on researchers finding a hatching line in the bones, that shows that there were subtle growth changes after hatching. So in only a few weeks, it grew 10 times in weight. This juvenile weighed about 88 pounds or 40 kilograms.
Oh, man.
And it was probably between 39 and 77 days old when it died. And it died possibly from starvation due to drought.
So compared to a human that at 2 months old weighs like, what, 10, 15 pounds. This one weighed over 80 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a teenager. That's pretty amazing. And they weighed about the same as a human at birth. If it was 7.5 pounds, it was a hatchling.
Yep.
That's amazing.
That's how they stayed safe, was growing quickly.
Seriously.
Rapetosaurus also probably didn't need parental care. Scientists think this because the shape and proportion of its limbs appear to stay constant, that isometry. So it looked like a mini adult when it was young. It was precocial because it could take care of itself. Also, the Rapetosaurus weight-bearing bones had signs of bone remodeling, and that's where the skeleton resorbs old bone tissue and replaces it. And that usually happens once animals can move around on their own. So that shows it was moving around.
Not stuck in a nest, just waiting for parents to bring back food kind of thing.
And it had thin cartilage deposits in its growth plates, similar to modern birds that are precocial. So animals that need parental care have thick, irregular cartilages.
Hmm.
The preserved cartilages also had, according to Christina Curry Rogers, quote, a distinctive structure that signals starvation in living animals. So that's why they think that this particular juvenile died of starvation due to drought.
Got more sauropods dying due to drought. We were talking about Mother's Day quarry the other day.
True. So this Rapetosaurus juvenile probably spent its time foraging, sleeping, and avoiding predators. Pretty active for so young. The juvenile was about 11% the body size of the largest known Rapetosaurus.
I wonder if they're going by body length, because it seems like at 88 pounds, it wasn't 11% of several tons.
Yeah, it was hard to find some clarification on that.
There's a lot of ways to measure size, I guess.
So Rapetosaurus lived on an island in a semi-arid climate in an area where sea levels were rising. Other animals that lived around the same time and place included fish, frogs, lizards, snakes, crocodilomorphs, mammals, and birds. And dinosaurs that lived around the same time and place included the Titanosaur vahini, Dromaeosaurid, Rahanavis, the Noasaurid, Mashikasaurus, and the Abelosaurid Mahjongasaurus. And Mahjongasaurus may have specialized in hunting sauropods because there have been tooth marks found on Rapetosaurus bones. So they definitely ate the sauropods, even if they didn't specifically hunt them.
In addition to hunting slash eating each other, because Mahjongasaurus was the first confirmed cannibalistic dinosaur.
Yep. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino. Or click the link on the left.